Hey, Jason here from Electric Bike Tech. I want to talk about E-BikeKit hub motors today. I want to basically just give you the difference between both, show you a little bit of the insides, and maybe you'll get a better understanding of which one's going to work best for your application. So we offer two motor types. One is a geared motor, that's what people call it. The other one is a direct drive motor. For simplicity, on the website, you're going to see them listed as performance, which is geared motor, and then you're going to see heavy duty, which is the larger direct drive motor. Performance comes in five sizes. You've got 700C, 26, 24, 20, and 16. Because it has a smaller diameter, we can do that. The larger one, the direct drive, or the heavy duty, that's gonna be 700, 26, 24, and 20 would be the smallest you can build with that. Now, why would you choose one over the other? And the main reason you would choose one over the other would be weight. How much total load is going on the bike or trike that you're building? Also, is it a bike or trike? So what I mean by that is the geared performance, anything over 250 pounds, forget about it. Under 250, you're probably gonna choose a performance geared motor. Over 250, you're gonna go with the heavy duty and the direct drive motor, okay? Because those are more durable. And I'm gonna show you why by taking a look inside each one of these. Here I have the insides of a geared motor. The insides of a geared motor, and why it's called a geared motor, is because you have a clutch and you have these three nylon cogs. Now, these cogs will fit into the shell of the motor, and that's what's going to actuate your wheel. This means that there's friction inside of here. This means that it can build up heat under pressure, say over 250 pounds, and with enough pressure, you could actually break the teeth. So this is why it's important that you go by total load over under 250, okay? This goes in here, turns, too much load on there, you may have problems. Otherwise, anyone under 250, this is performance because it's a little bit more torquey and it's got higher top speeds. So that's performance geared. So direct drive, what do the insides look like on a direct drive? Well, this one's already inside, and this we have a stator, and then we have the outer shell there. And what happens is you have two sets of rare earth magnets. They never touch. When you electrify them, they go one way or the other. That's one of the reasons why we can do reverse on this as well. So a direct drive motor is a bit heavier. You have a larger diameter, so less stealth, but it's super durable. So you can do 250, you can do up to 600 pounds kind of against this. And not saying that that's gonna be able to pull 600 pounds by itself, but it's not gonna break because there's nothing to break. It's only a magnetic field, and that's how this works. So direct drive, you're gonna go anything over 250 total pounds is gonna be direct drive. Also, if it's an upright trike or it's the E-Trike kit, which is made specifically for upright tricycles, it's gonna be a direct drive because you can actuate reverse on a direct drive. You can't do that with a geared motor. So I hope that explains some of the differences and gives you an inside look. I know it's brief. If you have other questions, you'll let us know, but those are how you would choose your motor. Under 250 geared, over 250 total load, you're going with direct drive.